Good morning. Well, yesterday I went to the Women and Children's Summit that was run by Women's Refuge, and I spoke at that conference. And I spoke about a subject which is really quite close to my heart, and that's about domestic violence. And some of the stats are, you know, I think some of the stats we all know about, one in three women over a lifetime can experience domestic violence. The national government this year is putting in $62.4 million for domestic violence prevention, which is actually an increase of just on $3 million, which is quite significant in the sense that we've been through really tough economic times, and the fact that we can increase the budget, particularly to frontline services and backing groups who know what they're doing, is, says something in itself, quite frankly. I was able to talk to the conference about a wonderful project that is backed by the Minister of Health, Tony Ryle, and has been run by the Ministry of Health, and that's about Violence Intervention Program. That's been going since 2004, and essentially it's women, any female over 16 years of age, is screened for domestic violence in our DHBs. Now, every DHB has a family violence coordinator who helps run the whole program and talks to staff about the screening that's involved. It began in the maternity wards, and now it's basically in all the DHBs. And there's been, it's just coming up for its second evaluation. And it's believed that probably only one in three women are being screened. So there's a lot more improvement. But the thing is here that women who are victims of domestic violence are actually high users of the health system. It's not just fractures and cuts and so forth. It's often with chronic stress, poor health, and you know, chronic illness can occur. So it's not just A&E stuff. It's all other sort of illnesses that imaginable. So we can say, not only can we, by intervening early, can be life changing for them, but can save the health system billions of dollars over time. So that's the win-win that's involved in this program. I think it's a real winner, and I'm looking forward to the second evaluation, because the results won't be anonymous. The first time round they were anonymous, and now with the second evaluations, DHBs can benchmark themselves to see how they're going. It's like everything, once you have some data out in the public arena, everyone steps up. The DHBs, for instance, have done a fantastic job on the six health targets that Tony Ryle has given them, and over time you can see the DHBs have stepped up and are seeing that as something to meet, and no one feels threatened by that. It's been well received, so I think it's a great program. But look, the national government is really backing the domestic violence services, and we really want to make sure our communities are safe for women and for families, not only through the violence programs that we're funding, but also just the fact we've passed 18 new laws this term, 18 new laws to make sure our communities are safe. There's going to be 600 more police by the end of this year. And Judith Collins is doing a fantastic job. I mean, reported crime rates in Auckland are dropping, and that's to the credit of the police and just all those groups on the ground working so hard. Anyway, look, that's all from me today. I hope to catch up with you, but if not, I'll see you after the election. Thank you.